So if you didn't watch the old show, I ought to explain this. When my late father was in the hospital winter before last, I read to him, especially the works of the great American humorist and comic illustrator James Thurber, and he said, you should do this on the show. And I said, it's a newscast, and besides, there are copyrights and licensing fees and stuff. And he said, how often have I suggested something like this? And I thought about it, and he never had previously. So with great trepidation, I read one of Thurber's fables, one of the more political ones, The Peace Like Mongoose, on the air. And sure enough, comes the next day, an email from the Thurber Literary Trust, and I'm thinking, it's a bill. In fact, it was a note from James Thurber's agents and his daughter, all of them viewers and all of them delighted I read the story. And they said I could read anything I wanted, any time I wanted. A year and a half later, and the Library of America has had to reprint its seminal anthology, Thurber Writings and Drawings, and we've just released the James Thurber audio collection, which you can get on iTunes and Amazon and everywhere else. And for the record, I don't get a penny. It's all to the estate and the Thurber house. So let's restart the tradition tonight with some of those fables. Some you have heard before and some you have not. The Sheep in Wolf's Clothing by James Thurber. Not very long ago, there were two sheep who put on wolf's clothing and went among the wolves as spies to see what was going on. They arrived on a fete day, when all the wolves were singing in the taverns or dancing in the street. The first sheep said to his companion, wolves are just like us, for they gamble and frisk. Every day is fete day in Wolfland. He made some notes on a piece of paper, which a spy should never do, and he headed them, My 24 Hours in Wolfland, for he had decided not to be a spy any longer, but to write a book on Wolfland and also some articles for the sheep's home companion. The other sheep guessed what he was planning to do, so he slipped away and began to write a book called My 10 Hours in Wolfland. The first sheep suspected what was up when he found his friend had gone, so he wired a book to his publisher called My 5 Hours in Wolfland, and it was announced for publication first. The other sheep immediately sold his manuscript to a newspaper syndicate for serialization. Both sheep, rather, gave the message to their followers. Wolves were just like sheep, for they gambled and frisked, and every day was fete land in Wolfland. The citizens of Sheepland were convinced by all this, so they drew in their sentinels and they let down their barriers. And when the wolves descended on them one night, howling and slavering, the sheep were as easy to kill as flies on a window pane. Moral? Don't get it right. Just get it written. The Sheep in Wolf's Clothing by James Thurber. And now, The Hen Who Wouldn't Fly by James Thurber. In one of the Midwestern states, there lived a speckled hen who was opposed to aviation. In her youth, watching a flight of wild geese going north, she had seen two fall, shot by hunters, go into a nosedive and crash into the woods. So she went about the countryside saying that flying was very dangerous and that any fowl with any sense would stick to the solid earth. Every time she had to cross a concrete highway near her farm, she ran on foot, screaming and squawking. Sometimes she made it easily. At other times, she was almost tagged by passing cars. Five of her sisters and three of her daughter's husbands were killed trying to cross the road in 1 month, July. Before long, an enterprising wood duck set up an airways service across the road and back. He charged 5 grains of corn to take a hen or a rooster across, 2 grains for a chick. But the speckled hen, who was a power in the community, went around clucking and cut-cutting and catacauding, and telling everybody that air travel was not safe and never would be. She persuaded the chickens not to ride on the duck's back, and he failed in business and returned to the forests. Before the year was out, the speckled hen, 4 more of her sisters, 3 of her sons-in-law, 4 aunts, and a grandfather had been killed trying to cross the road on foot. Moral? Use the wings God gave you, or nothing can save you. The Hen Who Wouldn't Fly by James Thurber. And lastly for tonight, The Peace Like Mongoose by James Thurber. In Cobra Country, a mongoose was born one day who didn't want to fight cobras or anything else. The word spread from mongoose to mongoose that there was a mongoose who didn't want to fight cobras. If he didn't want to fight anything else, it was his own business. But it was the duty of every mongoose to kill cobras or be killed by cobras. Why? Asked the Peace Like Mongoose. And the word went around that the strange new mongoose was not only pro-cobra and anti-mongoose, but intellectually curious and against the ideals and traditions of mongoosism. He's crazy, cried the young mongoose's father. He's sick, said his mother. He's a coward, shouted his brothers. He's a mongoose sexual, whispered his sisters. Strangers who had never laid eyes on the peace-like mongoose remembered that they'd seen him crawling on his stomach, or trying on cobra hoods, or plotting the violent overthrow of Mongoosia. "I'm trying to use reason and intelligence," said the strange new mongoose. "Reason is 6/7 of treason," said one of his neighbors. "Intelligence is what the enemy uses," said another. Finally, the rumor spread that the mongoose had venom in his sting like a cobra, and he was tried, convicted by a show of paws, and condemned to banishment. Moral? Ashes to ashes and clay to clay. If the enemy doesn't get you, your own folks may. The Peace-Like Mongoose by James Thurber. That's Countdown. Up next on Current, an extraordinary look inside the group Doctors Without Borders. Thanks for helping us preserve freedom of news. For everybody here at Current, I'm Keith Olbermann. Good night and good luck.